Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. We are back with a new video. If you like our content, please like the video and do share it. So let us start with the first news. The disengagement process between India and China has started along the Galwan Valley, where both the countries were on a standoff since long. According to the Indian Army sources, mutual disagreement between India and China along the border has begun at all the friction points. That means the four friction points along the line of actual control in Ladakh. That is Galwan Valley, Patrolling Point 15, Hot Springs and the finger areas located at the Pangong So Lake. The disengagement was a result of military level talks and representative level talks between India and China. On July 1, the military level talks, commander level talks were held at Chushul, and recently National Security Advisor of India Ajit Doval and Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi discussed about this issue over a telephone on July 5th. Ajit Doval and Wang Yi were the two special representatives from India and China respectively for the India-China border talks. So, a day before, the Chinese army have moved their tents, vehicles and troops by 2 kilometers from the Galwan Valley border. The two special representatives, Ajit Doval and Wang Yi, are expected to continue their discussions to ensure full restoration of peace and disengagement between the India-China border. As it is seen that the disengagement process between India and China will take some time, the Indian Army has given emergency orders for tents which would be used in extreme cold weathers in Ladakh. The Indian Army troops would be needing the extreme cold weather tents to remain at the Indian-China border in the eastern Ladakh sector at the line of actual control. The government of India have also given some financial powers of rupees 500 crore per procurement to the defense forces in order to address any types of shortages in ammunitions, weapons or such tent facilities requirement. The Madhya Pradesh government has announced the inauguration of Asia's largest single-site solar power plant in Madhya Pradesh's Rewa district. The solar generation capacity of this power plant at Rewa would be 750 megawatt. It is spread over 1590 acres of land, and so it is one of the largest single-site power plants in Asia. In India, there are two other solar parks which are bigger than the solar power plant at Rewa. The first is the solar park at Charanka village in northern Gujarat. This solar park in Gujarat is one of Asia's biggest solar park by area. And the solar park at Jodhpur, the Bhadla solar park in Rajasthan, is the third largest solar park in India. And this solar park at Rajasthan has the highest capacity, 2500 megawatt, to produce solar energy from it. The installation of the solar power project at Rewa was completed by a joint venture between the government's regional solar company and the Solar Energy Corporation of India. As per the reports, 1/4 of the power generated by the Rewa Ultra Mega solar plant will go to the Delhi Metro Rail services. Recently, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, has found evidence that there can be greater amounts of metal such as iron and titanium at the moon's subsurface. This thing was observed by the miniature radio frequency mini RF instrument, which is
on board the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter spacecraft, which is mission of NASA and in operation since 2009. The LRO orbiter searches for water or ice that could exist in permanently shadowed craters on the surface of Moon. Recently, the mini RF instrument was measuring the dielectric constant within the Moon's surface. The dielectric constant means the ratio of electric permeability of a material to the electric permeability of vacuum, means the conduction of electricity along the lunar surface. So according to this measurement of the NASA, they have found concentration of metal minerals in the surface of a Moon while they were surveying large craters along the lunar surface. And they have also said that these craters or the metal minerals are found because of the meteorite strikes with the Moon. I would also like to add one more thing, that the miniature radio frequency instrument, mini RF instrument, which was measuring the dielectric constant, is one of the two radar instruments launched to Moon to map the lunar poles, search for water and ice, and to demonstrate future NASA communication technologies. Among these two instruments of the mini RF, one instrument was launched on the Chandrayaan-1 mission of the ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, which has mapped both the polar regions of the Moon and has also proved the existence of water on Moon's surface. And the second instrument is currently flying on NASA's LRO orbiter, which has been mapping different geological units on the surface and the study of the craters on the surface of Moon. The wildlife sanctuary in Assam, Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary, will be now upgraded to a national park status, and this decision was taken on 6th of July by the Chief Minister of Assam after discussing with its cabinet. This decision was taken to protect the flora and fauna of the wildlife sanctuary and to protect the forest area which is covered under it. This decision also came after there were major protests held by the environmentalists in Assam in April 2020 because the National Board for Wildlife in its standing committee has passed the controversial decision for the approval of coal mining to the Coal India Limited's subsidiary, which is operational in Assam Northeastern Sector, that is Northeastern Coal Field NEC, inside the land of Saleki Proposed Reserved Forest. This Saleki Proposed Reserve Forest falls within the eco-sensitive zone, which is within the 10 km radius of the wildlife sanctuary Dehing Patkai. The exact distance between the Saleki Forest and the Dehing Wildlife Sanctuary is 9.1 kilometers. And so, according to the decision of the National Board for Wildlife for the approval of coal mining, there were major protests and the Assam government has suspended the operation of the Coal India Limited's coal mining in the forest area. Coal India Limited have been mining in the forest area since 2003 without any official clearances, and so the Forest Department of Assam has also imposed a penalty of rupees 43 crore on the Coal India Limited. Talking about the wildlife sanctuary, in 1992, Dehing Patkai was declared as the elephant reserve under the Project Elephant, which was launched at that time. And on June 2004, the Dehing Patkai was declared as wildlife sanctuary from elephant reserve. And now Dehing Patkai will be upgraded to the national park status. Moving on towards our last news. The Defense Research and Development Organization DRDO has established a 1,000-bed facility in 12 days near the domestic terminal of Indira Gandhi International Airport. This facility was inaugurated by the Defense Minister Rajnath Singh and the Home Minister Amit Shah during their visit on July 5th. This facility is named as the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel COVID-19 facility. The facility has a total of 1,000 beds for patients and 250 intensive care beds. This facility would be managed by the Indian Armed Forces Medical Services, so the team of doctors, nurses, healthcare staff and other staff which would be required by the facility will be provided by the Armed Forces Medical Services. Also, the Delhi District Administration made a COVID care center, which is India's biggest COVID care center and also said to be the world's biggest COVID care center with 10,000 beds in the Delhi's Chhatarpur area with the help of Union Ministry of Home Affairs. This would be the COVID care facility named as the Sardar Patel COVID care center and hospital, which will function as the isolation center for the mild and asymptomatic patients of the coronavirus disease. This COVID care center in Delhi's Chhatarpur area is the world's largest COVID care center of the size of 20 football fields with 10,000 beds. This COVID care center will be operated by the Indo-Tibetan Border Police ITBP with the help of Delhi government and the volunteers from the religious sect of Radha Somayi Bees. So this is it for today. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates from our channel.